taking the walk of death. So let's get cracking.
All right, what are we doing this time?
We have to test whether people can tell the difference between artificial or real foods.
Oh, you mean like citrus fruits?
Exactly.
Awesome. All right, so before we can even begin to think about how we're going to do this, we need to get our list of materials straight. So what kinds of fruits can we test?
Apples.
How about oranges?
Good one. Grapes.
What about lemons?
And I think we should have coffee beans to keep our experiment controlled.
Good idea, but we also need something to record it all with, so we need a camera.
And we need something to put everything in, like plastic cups.
Good idea. We're on a roll.
Alright, so how should we have this experiment go down?
Well, I think we should bring them into the test area already blindfolded.
Okay, sounds good. And then we can put them in a chair.
And then we'll have them smell the coffee beans before they go through round one. They'll go through round one, coffee beans again, round two, and then we'll carefully walk them out.
Carefully, right. Don't run into those. Watch out, chair. Watch out, you're gonna bump into some chairs on your left. Okay. Yeah, don't run into those. Okay.
Apple.
Lemon.
An orange.
Lime. Lime. Lime.
Apples.
Orange.
Apple.
Lemons.
Wait.
I don't smell anything. Oranges.
Fake grapes.
None. That was oranges, fake.
Fake apple.
Wait, that was lemons, fake. I think. Testing is done.
Alright, so what does our data reveal?
The first round, people had trouble just identifying the fruit, and then the second round, they got a lot better.
Yeah, but they did okay telling if it was real or fake, it was just what fruit it was.
You're absolutely right, and that may have to do with the fact that the artificial smells that we chose were really sugary and sweet, which made it a lot easier to identify. You know, I really don't think there's anything else that we can do to sniff and smell.
I think we can all count this myth tested.
Tested.